Hello children, we are here to discuss the video solutions for the assignment dated 8th of August, where the topic is mainly replication of DNA. So we'll go to the question paper first. So these are the questions for the assignment dated 8th. Sequence of enzyme acting in DNA replication is. So first there will be unwinding of the helix by helicase. Then tension will be relieved due to supercoiling by topoisomerase. Strands will be synthesized by DNA polymerase. Okazaki fragments will also be synthesized by DNA polymerase. And finally, the segments will be joined by ligase. So answer to the first question is the first option, helicases, then topoisomerases, then DNA polymerases, and then ligases. Then the second question, the replication of the lagging strand generates small polynucleotide fragments, which are called as Okazaki fragments, which is named after the scientist. And the length of these Okazaki fragments are 1000 to 2000 base pairs in prokaryotes and around 100 to 200 base pairs in eukaryotes. G.H. Taylor's experiment, which proved that DNA replication is semi-conservative, was done on the root tip cells of Vischia faba. So answer to this question is the second one. The isotope which was used by Meselson and Stahl in their experiment was N15. So answer to this question is the fourth option. Mode of DNA replication in E. coli is, it is semi-conservative and it is also unidirectional. It is semi-conservative and bi-directional because it takes place in both the directions. So if we just look at the replication fork, like this is the replication fork, then it is in both directions like this. And this is the parent strand and this is the newly synthesized strand. Okay, so it is semi-conservative and bi-directional. So in E. coli, it is semi-conservative and bi-directional. So answer to this question is the fourth option. During DNA replication in prokaryotes, DNA is attached to. So DNA is attached to a structure which is called as the mesosomes, which helps in the division of the daughter DNA molecules. Replication fork is children. It is a small opening of the DNA helix. So the DNA helix opens for a small amount and that forms a Y-shaped replication fork. So answer to seventh question is the second option. Okazaki fragments are seen during, of course, they are seen during the process of replication, which is formed on the template with polarity 5-3. Cairn used H3 and the technique of autoradiography to confirm the mode of replication in a bacterium. The nitrogen base labeled was thymidine. It was tritiated thymidine. So they had used the radioisotope of hydrogen, that is tritium. So it was tritiated thymidine. During DNA replication, the term leading strand is applied to one which replicates in 5-3. Always polymerization will be in 5-3, whether it is the leading strand or it is the lagging strand. But the difference is that the leading strand is synthesized continuously and the lagging strand is synthesized discontinuously. So the answer will be the first option. So with this, we end up the discussion on this topic of DNA replication, that is assignment dated 8th of August. Thank you, children.